With the PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X consoles, a new big number has crawled into the light of day. 8K. There's nothing worse than a technology buzzword when it comes to gaming consoles. You may be old enough to remember the console wars where terms like blast processing and how many bits a console had dominated the conversation around these devices. Marketers love simple numbers where more is better. It means a potential buyer can look at two products and pick the one with the higher number, even if they don't really understand what those numbers mean. So, what does 8K mean? The terms high definition, full high definition, 4K ultra high definition, and 8K are all just shorthand for different resolution standards. That is, how many rows and columns of pixels an image consists of, or a particular display, can show you. An FHD display has 1920 columns and 1080 rows of pixels arranged in a grid. That's a total of 2,073,600 pixels. A 4K display doubles both those numbers to 3840 by 2160. Multiplying the columns by rows yields 8,294,400 pixels, exactly 4 times the number of Full HD. 8K quadruples that figure again to 7680 by 4320 for 33,177,600 pixels. That's a whopping 4 times the resolution of 4K and 16 times the resolution of Full HD. The higher the pixel count of a screen, the more fine detail you can see, assuming it has an image of the same quality to display. Although the amount of detail that's in the picture isn't the same as the amount of detail that the human eye can actually see. Unlike a pre-recorded movie, a video game has to calculate the exact value of each pixel on screen in real time. Since video games are interactive, the image can't be prepared beforehand. You control camera movement and choices made in the game, so an extremely tight feedback loop exists from when you give the game commands using a controller and the image on screen changes in response. While the level of difficulty in rendering, that's all the math needed to make the picture, doesn't scale in a straight line as resolution goes up, it's not that far off. This implies that to render a game at 8K, you need up to 16 times the processing power compared to rendering it at Full HD. If you can't increase the amount of processing power the console or computer has, then you have to resort to other methods of reducing the workload on it. For example, you can reduce the frame rate, providing more time to do the math for each image, but with choppier motion. You can also decrease the quality of the render, for example, shadow detail or particle effects. In both cases, you're trading detail in another area to free up resources for a higher resolution. So you might have a sharper image, but the render is less pleasing to look at or runs with less fluidity. I have little doubt that there will be some titles that offer an 8K resolution mode at some point in the future. There are many simpler video games that would have no trouble running well at this resolution. I also expect that some backwards compatible games from the PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360 generation and older could get 8K resolution enhancements at some point in the future. Running brand new AAA quality games with 8K on existing console hardware can safely be considered out of reach, at least if games are rendered at native 8K resolution. These days, video games can use dynamic resolution technology to render each frame at the resolution required to achieve a specific frame rate. So, it's conceivable that some games could dynamically target 8K, although rarely reach it. Today, even if you own one of the rare and incredibly expensive 8K displays on the market, you still won't be able to get 8K output from either the PS5 or Xbox Series X. There are no games on either platform that support this resolution, despite 8K being advertised on the new packaging prominently. It's a feature that still needs to be enabled by a software update at some point in the future. The only place you can currently play games in 8K is on a gaming PC. Even then, using the most powerful gaming hardware on Earth doesn't offer great results, with serious compromises or upscaling technology needed to achieve playable frame rates. With the latest generation of consoles, 8K resolution isn't all that relevant. However, there are other aspects of these machines that are worth looking into for the average player. The CPUs in the PS5 and Xbox Series X are powerful enough to make high frame rate gaming possible. If you have a TV that supports 120Hz visuals, then you can enjoy a growing number of games that have 120 frames per second mode. This offers hyper-smooth motion and razor-sharp responsiveness. In most cases, this comes at the cost of resolutions below 4K or even below Full HD, but it has a much more dramatic effect on gameplay than an 8K resolution ever could. The sweet spot for this generation thus far is gaming at 60 frames per second at a resolution targeting 4K. This is achievable for many cross-generation or previous generation titles. At normal viewing distances, 4K is noticeably sharper than Full HD, and doubling the frame rate from the last generation's 30 frames per second to 60 is a dramatic improvement. Virtually all modern flat panel displays support 60Hz output, so it's also a much more accessible option than 120Hz output. One of the biggest problems with 8K as a concept is that we're reaching the limits of how much detail the human eye can actually perceive, at least when it comes to typical viewers sitting at normal viewing distances relative to the size of the screen. Early in 2020, results of a study were published where participants took part in a double-blind experiment. Each participant was shown either an 8K or a 4K image and had to rate which looked better. On average, most people can't tell the difference, although interestingly, people with better than 20/20 vision could tell what was 8K or not with more accuracy. The overall conclusion is that the perceived improvements from 4K to 8K is one that most people can't see, and even those who can don't rate it as particularly dramatic. That's a different situation from the obvious increase in sharpness going from Full HD to 4K. Then again, a Full HD image is hardly blurry, judged on its own merits. Even 4K becomes indistinguishable from FHD if you're sitting too far from the screen relative to its size. So, what's the bottom line? Gaming at 8K requires massive amounts of processing power, which consoles and even top-end PCs don't have at the moment, unless the game is older or relatively simple. 8K televisions and 8K content is nearly non-existent at the moment. A 4K resolution with better refresh rates, contrast, and color will create a much more dramatic perceived image quality improvement than 8K by itself. I don't recommend at this time that anyone should spare a thought for 8K. It will be a long time, if ever, for this next step in resolution to become relevant, and it certainly isn't going to be practical on current PS5 and Xbox Series X consoles. See you next time.